brings us to reevaluate our belief system, so much the better. See, our initial resistance is a reservation in our willingness. Trying new things in recovery is one way we keep ourselves from getting stuck. No matter how long we have been clean, we can go to meetings and listen to the music. It's like when your ears pop, a member shared. Suddenly, I could hear what I didn't know I was missing before. Living Clean Approval Draft for Decision at WSC 2012. 12. Our tradition teaches that in NOD there are no classes of membership. It follows that the new member is as likely to save the life of the old timer as the reverse. When we stay open to that reality, many of the limitations we set for ourselves disappear. We teach by example. Even when we are teaching what not to do, we are still carrying a message. Sharing our experience gives us meaning and value. Our hope is that the next member will do better than we did, that they can learn from our mistakes. It doesn't always work. We are people who tend to learn things the hard way. But when a member with 2 years clean shares with us that the experience we had at 10 years clean kept them from doing the same thing, we know that we are getting better, personally and as a fellowship. Wisdom is building on past experience to cope with new events. When we think about our lives now in contrast to our active addiction, it is important to remember that it is not where we have been that count, but where we are going. Where we have been in recovery is the foundation of our system.
Yeah.
aspect of this crucial point when there is nothing left to blame or change but ourselves. Selfishness and self-centeredness die hard. But we can get through it with the help of others who have survived this passage, and we find great gifts are waiting for us on the other side. What we heard when we were new still stands. Keep coming back, no matter what. Many of the challenges we face have concrete symptoms, but are actually spiritual in nature. It's hard to spot a spiritual crisis. Usually it is disguised as a crisis in our relationships, finances, career, or family. When we are in crisis, we may try all kinds of escapes and excuses before we resort to the steps. Intolerant, angry, defensive, vengeful, guilty, and resentful, testing the patience and tolerance of those around us. The only way out is through. We must roll up our sleeves and get to work. These struggles often push us into the next phase in our recovery. We can come out stronger and healthier people for the experience, if we are willing to do the work. Early in recovery, we were told that if we kept coming to meetings, sooner or later we would hear our story. It would be a mistake to think that our using story is the only one we need to listen for. Our recovery story is no less dramatic, and there are times when we need just as much to go to meetings and listen for that. We hear it when we learn to listen with our heart as well as our ears. Sometimes we have to go looking for it, seeking new meanings, asking around, and sharing about what's going on. We find people who have been through what we're going through, and got through it clean. We need other people to walk us through hard times, and we need to reach out and help others as we heal. We're a hope. When we listen to others share their pain and how they get through it, we get a broader view. We see new tools in action, and we can learn to use their experience to go forward in our own lives. When we change our attitude or perspective, we can find a new sense of compassion and gratitude. Perhaps the most valuable lesson of all is empathy. However, empathy isn't a treatment plan, it's a way of life. When we can relate with one another and see each other's growth, we begin to believe in the possibility of our own recovery. Listening to other addicts share without judging them is the beginning of listening to our own heart without judgment or punishment. When we have compassion for ourselves, we give ourselves permission to be in the world, and that makes us much more useful to the world. Living Clean Approval Draft for Decision at WSC 2012. 14. Our ability to feel joy and gratitude can be a direct result of the suffering we have endured. Staying clean is not a guarantee that nothing bad will happen, but the principles and the steps teach us how to live on life's terms and give us the courage, strength, and wisdom to stay clean no matter what. We are able to live lives of joy and purpose no matter what we have been through. Faith is what keeps us doing the footwork even when we can't see the reason. One of the benefits of reaching out is finding that our most painful experiences can help someone else. When we say, I've been through that, and I've stayed clean, we realize with gratitude that we have gotten honest with ourselves and others. More often, and sooner in the process, we are able to recognize our responsibility for our actions and motives. Identifying what drives us to act as we do helps us to find relief from all the ways our disease shows up. It also gives us the ability to see more clearly. We begin to move toward what we want rather than just away from what we fear. Each time we let go, there is a degree of mourning and then an opening of possibility. Each time we get through that process, we find new freedom in ourselves. But it can take years to let go enough to feel that freedom. We hang on fiercely, mistaking the attempt to control all the variables in our lives for vigilance in our recovery. Letting go looks different at different times in our recovery. Making peace with loss is one way we learn acceptance. When we experience loss and find that we can still feel complete within ourselves,